Welcome back to Hot Copy. We're talking with Eric Lachica, organizer of the US Medicare Philippines Incorporated. Now, very quickly, Eric, for those who are watching, hindi nila alam ang talagang benepisyo ngayon ng Phil-American veterans because of your efforts. Ikwento mo muna. So now, a Phil-American veteran, what can he take home?
Well, he can,
ano yung benepisyo niya?
Yeah, he can take his called SSI, Supplemental okay. Security Income, which is about $500 a month.
Oh, yeah, that's a lot.
Yes. Right now, he can avail of burial benefits only in the United States. Okay. Hindi madala rito.
Uh-uh.
And of course, you know, if his widows would get benefits if he filed a claim for that 9,000 pesos, $9,000.
All right. Now, what if they're sick?
Well, they have to go to the Veterans Memorial Center here in Quezon City.
No, but abroad, in the ones who are living in the U.S.
Oh, yeah, they get an ID card from the U.S. Department of Veterans Affairs. 100% sagot ng Uncle Sam.
So, una ang Phil-Am veterans natin in the U.S. You succeeded. I know it's amounting to $300 million in total.
Mm-hmm.
All right. So, they get $500 a month?
Yung kanilang SSI, kung gumalik sila rito.
Kung dito, pero doon.
They get that already. Part of the, kasi parang old age pension yan sa US. Eh. Any elderly person who is low income would get at least $800. But if that's a Filipino World War II veteran, want to come back here, he would get the at least 75%. We made that breakthrough back in 99.
All right. So now you are fighting for that if you're a Philippine-American veteran, that if you want Medicare or hospitalization, you want that Medicare will also be, in other
portable.
Words, portable dito. And accepted here.
Right.
Kunyari, if let's say the PhilAm wants to choose St. Luke's, Makati Med.
Right.
Sa ngayon,
yes, the veterans are leading the way on the Medicare portability. Kasi in America, kung 65 and above ka, you will get Medicare coverage, parang national health insurance for the seniors. And we're expanded the base kasi ang mga veterans sa US, hindi pwede madala yung kanilang healthcare dito. So, in addition to the 200,000 mga US Filipino seniors, you know.
Where, here?
From the US.
Wanting to come here.
Oh, yes. The retirement you know, business would just boom.
Yes.
We expect $1 billion of Medicare spending. Kung payagan tayo ni President Obama and the U.S. Congress, we have to change Medicare law para madala yung kanilang, they pay into the system. I would be paying $55,000 into the healthcare system.
Taxes, in the U.S.?
In the U.S. I'd like to retire here or spend a long-term stay here.
Yeah, and it, and frankly speaking, in the Philippines, I mean, medical care is of the highest standards, but it's cheaper.
Yes,
much. I mean, I would not want to be living or paying Medicare in the U.S., frankly.
Yes.
I mean, ang mahal. Magpatanggal ka lang ng ngipin dun eh.
Okay.
Magkano ba ang dentista dun?
Mga $120.
No, really? Isipin mo yun?
Visit lang yun.
Diba? Visit lang, consultation. Alright, one question from Facebook. John Quinn says, there are many American veterans residing here in the Philippines that have little access to earned healthcare benefits. Would you team up with them? How do we contact you?
Yes, please do. We're working closely with your senior groups here, advocacy groups, the veterans, VFW. You can always go to our website, usmedicareph.org, and please sign up, join our campaign. You can become a member. We'll be back and forth. We have leaders in different parts of the Philippines, mm-hmm. So you can contact. So please contact us by email, on our website. That would be the best way. Talk to the U.S. ambassador, since you're a U.S. citizen, and you know this is an election year. You can vote here.
Yes.
You can vote here in the Philippines. You can even fax in your request for a ballot. You can do it by mail, so there's no excuse not participating.
Yes. Okay. All right. Christelle is saying, Lachica is such a big inspiration. This is my Twitter account. Actually, 5 bills passed. You got 5 bills passed. 7 years doing this, all right? 17 years. Okay. There was another question here. May nagtanong nga dito. Why were we discriminated? Yun ang tanong nila.
Why?
Why?
Well, it the history, the colonial history, as you know, even Filipinos were not allowed to get married to Americans, mga puti, during
Are
the oh yeah,
oh.
up until 1962, Filipino immigrants.
I didn't know that.
Oh, there was they had an anti-miscegenation law. Up till 1962, you couldn't marry a white woman in California if I was a guy. So in different parts of, I have friends, older friends, had to get married to their fiancé na puti in Colorado or different states. And under then, you know, you would be your children would have been recognized as legitimate. So
yeah.
Those are little footnotes in Philippine American history. So discrimination is a two-way street. Unfortunately, you know, if you allow it to, you have to fight against discrimination.
Yeah.
And the biggest challenge right now, especially many of our nurses who are subjected to. You know, discrimination because on their private time they talk to their fellow Filipino nurse kaibigan in Tagalog, but some under some in some hospitals.
Some hospitals, ayaw.
Oh, you can get fired or get disciplined.
Really? You mean you can get fired in some hospitals for speaking in Tagalog?
Oh, there are a lot of cases. Oh,
grabe, no.
Oh, oh. And sad to say that many of our, you know, H-1B teachers also been laid off, you know, in especially in Maryland, and many of them moved just recently to Arizona just to find jobs to keep their visa status. So those are the things that our Philam community leadership are concerned about, especially our TNT population. We have mm-hmm. a high number of undocumented. They say up to 10% of our community in the United States are out of status, you know.
Yeah. Yeah. No, clearly you have a heart for Filipinos who are in the United States.
Mm-hmm.
Clearly. What would you want to see Filipinos become in the U.S.?
They have to empower themselves. It takes from the heart and mind to say that they are Americans and they should play by American rules and they should support their, share that, you know, pride with the their children. Many... unfortunately, parang nahiya sila na pushing Filipino American identity.
I dapat think that's hindi.
You know, it's a very colonial mentality that they have to overcome. I'm being upfront. Kasi it's a persistent problem. Eh. They have to overcome the baggage from the colonial.
Yeah.
Parang, you know, they're already American, so why should they be ashamed of being their heritage?
Oh. But maybe they're ashamed to say, I'm Phil-American. They just say, I'm American.
Yeah, that's another thing, you know. I can tell you stories.
Yeah.
Maskin yung cashier sa isang drugstore sa LA, you know, kinausap ko ng Tagalog, parang nahiya siya kasi kinakausap ng Tagalog. I want to dramatize that for our young people watching, you know. They have to be more assertive, especially if they plan to...
We have to be proud first to be Filipino, and then we can carry that anywhere in the world, wherever we are.
Exactly.
Exactly, right? Mm. Okay, your last words, Eric. What, ano ba ang nais mo pang mangyari? Itong Medicare portability, ikwento mo to? How can we help you with this?
Yes, for one thing, we'd like to thank the President Aquino for his taking a forward-looking stance that he's bring this up with the highest levels of the Obama administration. Mm-hmm. We need his support, especially when they meet in the White House. And I think by June, the Philam community will be out there to welcome him. And the we have a lot of optimism with the mm-hmm. Aquino administration.
Have you met President Aquino already? Do you have a meeting with him?
I met him twice already.
No, but in this trip?
Yes, at the 2 weeks ago at the chamber, joint chamber luncheon. We have a tentative meeting on Monday with Ms. Lloyd and Lewis, and U.S. Pinoys.
Will you talk about with Pinoy?
Well, just to thank him and give him some pointers that we need also a very assertive partnership with the Philippine ambassador in Washington, D.C., Ambassador Quisia, that we have to work closely together to make his visit a success. There are many items on the agenda, both on bilaterally and on our community side. We have to have a working partnership, thanks to our meeting to Secretary Del Rosario two days ago. Hopefully that will materialize in the next few days.
All right. Thank you so much, Eric Lachica.
Thank you. Pleasure.
We are proud of you, and you make me proud.
It's an honor to be here.
No, really. Uh-oh. It's an honor to meet you.
All right.
That's Head Start today, everyone. I'm Karen Davila. And you know what? Interesting lesson for today. Wherever you may be, you have to remember, Whether you end up European, American, in the end, you are still Filipino, right? Mm-hmm. So tomorrow, okay, this is going to be hot and feisty. Miss Annabel Rama is going to be on Headstart. All right, so stay up for that, everyone. See you tomorrow. Have a good day. Thank you. See impeachment coverage.